Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, I wanted to talk about career considerations, especially for people who have just started working in their early 20s. And I've been working in corporate America for almost 2 years now, and there's a lot of things that I've learned to prioritize and want for myself for the rest of my career. And these aren't things that I necessarily thought about in college, so I thought I'd share, and hopefully these ideas and thoughts that I'm going to list to you help you decide where you stand in your job and how you feel about where you are. And let's get started. So the first thing I would say is feeling valued and appreciated wherever you are. And this is something that I don't say lightly, and something that may seem obvious, but a lot of people feel stuck and not valued and not credited enough for the work that they're doing and where they are. It's really important to evaluate how you feel and how you think your self-esteem is in the job that you're working in, and recognizing whether or not you are getting the appropriate credit and support from the place that you're working for. I think when it comes to a job, there is give and take. Obviously, the only thing you shouldn't be receiving in return for the work you're doing is money. You should also be receiving mentorship, training, support, potential for progression. So these are all things that I want to make you guys consider and really think about. And speaking of potential for progression, that really comes to my next point. Feeling like not just that you're happy where you are, but that there is a future where you could be. And the best way of evaluating that is looking at somebody who's a year or two older than you in the next position and how they are doing, how they are coping. Are they happy where they are? How is the responsibilities different from what your job is currently? Whether you feel like being in that position can create a big value add for your career and your long-term goals. And this is something that my mentor from my first internship at JP Morgan had told me. Like, if you look around in your team and you can't find somebody that you'd want to be in 5 years career-wise, like, you're probably not in the right position, or you probably don't want to see yourself in that team long-term. So this is something I took really close to heart, and I always follow to this day. I would say another thing is valuing work-life balance. I mean, obviously, I've been working in investment banking, which is a path really not well known for work-life balance. But yet, it has made me appreciate the concept of work-life balance more than ever. Obviously, you sometimes sacrifice time when you pick a certain job in your life. But you shouldn't let that stop you from living your life, or at least prioritizing yourself a little bit every day. And this is something that I really had to remind myself of with any job, that it's a lot of setting deadlines, setting guidelines for yourself and sticking to them, and not forcing yourself to just stare in front of a computer screen. Especially given COVID, there isn't like flow around and seeing other people leave or enter the office. So it's on you to create that time for yourself, regardless of how much work you have going on. Because at the end of the day, this is a job and you are a human and you need to live your life. And you definitely don't want to regret spending your early 20s in front of a computer the entire time. That got very serious, but I do think it is something that needs to be said. Lastly, I think impact is super important. If you feel like the work you're doing is helping the team, helping the company, helping the culture in some way, shape, or form, even at the lowest level, there are things that you contribute and should feel like you are being a part of a larger purpose, and rather than just a paper pusher. So this is something that obviously as you go in a job, the more you can give to the team and become a value add. But even from the get-go, you have to see that there is a future for you to be that value add later on in the team, and that you are prioritized, and that you do feel like you can add value or add something new to the place that you're in. Hopefully this was helpful. I think this is things that I have been thinking about, that I've been writing down. It's super important to constantly check in with yourself. I think especially with the job that doesn't really have a definitive end, right? Like, there's always been an end goal to college, an end goal to high school. But with your career, there's 40 years, and it's on you to take a lot more initiative than you ever have in your life. So recognizing that and taking action on it, not really feeling ever that you're too complacent, that you're never not learning. Because there's definitely parts of the job where you should feel like, okay, I'm so good at this that I don't need to really think twice about executing this task. But there should always be something or another each day, each week that you are feeling like you are still learning and still growing. Because I would say, like, if you in a month haven't done anything new, that's somewhat a problem. And it's not that that particular role doesn't have room for you to grow anymore. Maybe it's on you to take on more things and ask your manager and have a conversation on additional responsibilities you can take on or different projects. There's a lot more, like I said, initiative and a lot more self-control when it comes to jobs. Which is something I'm also trying to find the right place and the right balance of growing, but also growing outside of my job as well. So thank you guys again for listening. Sometimes when I create these videos, it's also a reminder to myself, advice that I've compiled, not just from my own experiences, but from what people tell me to prioritize. And I kind of mesh them all together to make this video. And hopefully you guys do find it helpful, and I'll catch you guys soon. Bye.